The first one is, God, that was 2010. So this is real early Earl. It's called Earl Sweatshirt, or it's by Earl Sweatshirt, and it's called Earl. The second one is from the album Doris. It's 2012, and it is called Whoa. And Tyler, the creator, does the fucking verse. And we're also going to talk about another one from 2012 called Chum, also by Earl. And the first two are similar. The last is really different. Okay, and I'm telling you this because this is what we want to work towards. Like, for you to have one delivery, but then for you to be able to pick up other ones. And Earl is actually going to show us how to think of your voice as an instrument, all right? So when we listen to him, we're going to be paying attention for his rhythms, how high, low his voice is, how loud, soft his voice is, how many rhymes he has, how wordy the rap is, and other stuff like that, okay? Because I promise you that Earl worked on delivering his, he worked on developing his delivery in the same way, all right? So we're just going to quick listen to some examples. I'm going to let him go on. We're going to listen to the first one. I'm going to ask you some questions about it. We're going to listen to the second one. I'm going to ask you more questions. And then after the third one, we'll do some final commentary and then go over it together. All right?
Okay.
All right, yeah. All right, this is Earl. You know this song?
Yo.
That was a pretty good introduction to him. So I'm telling you now that, like, that is his go-to delivery. That is, like, his guitar plucking the strings, you know? So, yeah, so just anything, what did you, if you could, yeah, and I can play it louder next time, actually. So what, yeah, what did you think of his rap? First thing that comes to mind, thinking of his voice like an instrument.
Like, very chill, like, kind of like that 90s type feel,
yeah.
Like.
Yeah, exactly.
Joey badass type, you know, like that kind of feel, you know,
yeah.
Wasn't aggressive or anything.
No, yeah, not aggressive. So his delivery isn't aggressive, right? But at the same time, he's got lyrics like, sent to earth to poke Catholics in the ass with saws and knock blunt ashes into their caskets and laugh it off. So his delivery isn't aggressive, but is his lyrics aggressive?
Yeah, you can say that, yeah.
Yeah, exactly, right? And so, yeah, so... Not aggressive delivery, aggressive lyrics. And so, what about his rhymes? Did he have a lot of rhymes or not many rhymes?
He had a lot, like a lot of internal rhymes,
yeah.
Multi-syllable rhymes, you know.
Yeah, complex, long, multi,
yeah.
Right? Yeah, how about his voice? You know, his voice itself, like, was it like, hi, like up here? Or like, was it low, like down here?
It was pretty low.
Yeah,
I would say
right?
It was pretty low.
It was low register, right? So this is actually, to an extent that, like, you know, like you were saying, maybe Drew Morrissey doesn't recognize, like, this is all kind of stuff that has been covered before in music, right? That people have their vocal registers, and they have the parts where they sound best. So even, like, famous singers like Freddie Mercury from Queen, they have what's called tessitura. And so your tessitura is where your voice is most comfortable. So rather than singing, though, we're not looking for our singing tessitura. We're looking for our rap tessitura. So, like, when you deliver or when you pronounce the words you write for your rap, try it out in lots of different ways. That's your first suggestion. Try it out,
yeah.
Lots of different ways. Yeah, like go.
I've tried it out before, and like aggressive, you know, whatever, like, different styles. But I think the best one I felt was, you know, like, non-aggressive chill, because I guess that's how I am as a person.
Yeah, exactly, right? Exactly. Like, your musical, I'm not saying that, like, Kendrick Lamar, that's where you need to start, right? Is that, like, your music, your rap style should be a reflection of who you are as a person. And I'm not saying that, like, that is always true for every rapper, but I think that's the easiest way to start. So actually something that might be good would be for, and you can do this if you want, send me some of your songs that, like, have lots of your different deliveries, and I'll tell you about what I think of them. And then we can work on the delivery you think is best. Would that be cool?
I actually don't have any music now. I'm trying to work on some right now. Trying to make an album with one of my friends. It's going to be an acoustic kind of album. But I do have, I have written, so I can say them right now if you want.
Yeah. Can we do that in, like, 10 minutes? Because I want to wrap up this conversation a little bit. Yeah, okay, that's fine then. Let's do that then. The next thing was, you got to think of it like an instrument, right? So an Earl Sweatshirt, you know, like a guitar, how you, like, tune it, and then you pick the strings, and you pick the bridges to, pick the amplifiers, and then, like, the tab, the thickness of the tab, right? This is what Earl Sweatshirt basically does with his voice. He picks his vocal register, how many rhymes, how aggressive his delivery, how active his rhythms, how wordy it is. So what we're looking for you is to create, like, the Omar rap instrument, kind of, right? So let's just say, like, I mean, yeah, because talking to you now, you seem pretty chill and laid back. So let's just say that, like, that for you is the delivery we're going to work on, right? Then what I can do is I can push you people who I think have good, chill, laid back deliveries and ask you to listen to them. Probably different songs rather than just one artist, you know, because rap is kind of like inherently an aggressive, you know. So now we've got a handle on Earl by Earl, right? So now we're going to see how another time when he brought back this same exact instrument. So now I want you to point out on this song what is similar between this one, it's called Whoa, and the last one we just listened to called Earl, all right?
Fuck that.
That's Tyler's.
Niggas think
creator.
You fucking made chum and got all personal. That niggas don't go back to that old fucking 2010 shit. About talking about fucking me and all that. No, fuck that, nigga. I got you. Fuck that. Grab me and swaff to spit. Blizzard is actually flicking cigarette ash and bitch. Niggas harassment. 8 nickels I hash. Delay quicken and dash to St. Nicholas pad to taste venison. Still in the venison. Racking up little rappers with rackets. You play tennis with hating for bank.
Sorry. Sorry, hold on. Let me start over.
Still in the business of smacking up little rappers with rackets. You play tennis with hating for bank. Flipping his brand and how to win. The shade of his main innocence. Suitcase in it with haze and filet sentences. Advanced apathy smashing a man. Cameras up. Tan khakis and antagonist. Dan dappered up. Vagabond had a sense of Padawan. Rapping hot as fucking cattle brands. Wearing flannel thongs. Grab a ball my mess. Food, beer, tag along. Get a nice spanking. New Sears catalog.
Alright, so that was the second song. So that's pretty similar to Earl, the first song we heard, right? That's pretty similar, right?
Yeah.
So what do you think was similar about it?
I guess just the delivery, I would say.
Yeah. Like, kind of...
The rhyming scheme also is kind of similar, too.
Yeah, exactly, right. So this is him thinking of his voice as an instrument. And that's, he found his best delivery, right? You know, he's kind of just like, well, shit, man, if I never got another delivery, I could just fucking rap like that all day. Because that's, I mean, all you need is one delivery. And MF Doom is fucking perfect proof of that. MF Doom's got one delivery, bro. So whether it's like Vomit Spit or anything else from Food, that album, it's really similar. And Earl Sweatshirt himself even cops to this, kind of. On his one song, Hive, he's got a line that goes like, dispelling one trick pony myths and simultaneously dispelling one trick pony myths, isn't he? Because on this rap, it's kind of a little different. So we're gonna get to your writtens real quick. But first I want to talk about to listen to a different Earl Sweatshirt instrument, and that one's on Chum.
Something sinister to it. Pendulum swinging slow, a degenerate moving through the city with criminal stealth. Welcome to enemy turf, harder than immigrants. Work office just in my shirt. Get up off the pavement, brush the dirt up off my psyche. Psyche. It's probably been 12 years since my father left. Left me fatherless. And I just used to say I hate him in dishonest jest. When honestly I miss this nigga like when I was 6. And every time I got the chance to say it, I would swallow at 16. I'm hollow intolerant, skip shots of storm. That whole bottle I show you a role model. Drunk pissing on somebody front lawn. Trying to figure out how and when the fuck I miss moderate.
Alright, so that's Chum. So that's like a different Earl Sweatshirt one, right? So if we're talking about just Earl's voice, what's different on that song, do you think?
Well, he's adding more bass, I think. Just, like, it's slower than it usually is.
His voice? I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just, I guess.
Yeah, anything else stand out to you?
It's not chill anymore. It's a little more, like, harder.
Exactly,
like,
right? Yeah, it's harder. But at the same time, his delivery is harder. His lyrics are more vulnerable, right? He's talking about how Earl's, he's talking about how Tyler was his big brother, right? Searching for a big brother, Tyler was that. He, you know, because he's talking about when his mom sent him away to Samoa and everyone freaked the fuck out. So, yeah, right? His delivery is harder, but his lyrics are softer. So, what about the tone of his voice? Did it move up and down a lot, or did it, like, stay at one level the whole fucking time, just like this?
I think it went down, like, I guess towards the ending of the rhyme scheme, like, it would say something.
I'm asking you, yeah, so do you think it went up and down more than it did on his other ones, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So listen here. I've got a better example for that, because that goes a long way towards improving your delivery. You know, because it's really easy to say what you want, and it's easy to say it how you want it, but it's hard to do both those things at the same time. And that's what rapping is. So like delivery, it just becomes a matter of being able to unify those two things to say what you want, how you want to. Because a lot of times rappers who aren't as good, they're worried that they won't say what they want, and then their delivery comes off as flat. And then at other times they worry too much about how they're saying what they're saying, and then their writtens aren't as good. So what we need to do is we have to develop your ear for tracking these pitches, right? So Eminem is actually a really good example. So I'm gonna play you some Eminem. And then we're gonna listen to some Earl, and then we'll get to your writtens, all right?
Yeah, what up? Hey, so Krabby's right, I'm just a crazy. Give me the mic, let me recite to Timothy White. Tickets outside, they're gonna scope off, this is every night. What if he's right, I'm just a criminal, making a living off of the world's misery. What in the world gives me the right to say what I like and walk around flipping the bird, living the herb in life like a white kid from the bird. Screaming at night and screaming at mom, scheming to leave. Run away from home and grow to be as evil as me. I just want you all to notice me and people to see that somewhere deep down is a decent human being in me. It just can't be found. So the reason you've been seeing this me is cause this is me now. The reason dude is being is me. So when you...
Alright, that right there was a perfect example of what I'm talking about. Like, part of the reason people love Eminem's rap so much is because he almost sings it. He moves his voice up and down a lot. Right? Like, sometimes it's really up here, and sometimes it's all the way back down here. And the thing that's amazing about him is that he can go so far, but never lose the beat, right? So if I were to imitate him, it almost goes like this. Give me the mic, let me recite till Timothy White. Pickets outside the Interscope offices every night. What if he's right? I'm just a criminal, making a living off of the world's misery. What in the world gives me the right to say what I like and walk around flipping the bird? you know? So sometimes it was really up here, and sometimes it was really down here. So, like, that's another thing for you to try out, is moving your voice up and down. And that's the third thing I said. It's like, that's another good way for you to improve your delivery, is for you to write things you would actually say and then think about how you would say them, right? Because, like, if you say, this is another good thing, like, write one rap line and try to say it five different ways. Because that's actually what we do in real life, really. Like truly. So, like, take something simple like, I'll see you later. So, if I'll see you later, that's your one line of rap, right? You can develop your delivery by trying to say that one line in five different ways. Because the five different ways you say it are really what matters when people hear it, are really what matters, what determines how people interpret it, right? So that's what you were saying before, like, the written text of rap is almost besides the point if you don't know how to deliver it, right? So you got to be able to say it. Think of how you would say your lines if you were actually talking to someone. Because I know that, like, I have my own way of speaking. Like, I, a lot of times, it's funny, I don't think I've done it today, but, like, I'll end my sentences with yo. I'm like, yo, man, that shit was whack, yo. You know, so, like, you have to think of how you actually speak. And even just this one, like, let's take this line. It's like, I'll see you later. Like, a bad rapper might say it like, I'll see you later, you know. But you got to think of how you would say it. Or if you're a super fucking badass, how you would say it. So you might do something like, man, I'll see you later. And then your delivery becomes better because it's more interesting, because it has more variety to it, right? Like, nope, see you later. And then, right, I mean, I basically just wrote a rap couplet for you, right? Because that's the ending. That's the punchline. So that's your second bar. And now all you need is a first bar. So, and again, I started writing that rap only from thinking about what is interesting to say. You know, because most of the time when people talk, like, they just talk, like I am now. But, like, when you have a question, your voice goes up. Or when you're saying goodbye, you're more, like, demonstrative. You're more active. You're like, all right, see you later. Like, your voice gets louder. So that's how you make your delivery more interesting, by thinking about the normal ways in which you change your pitch. All right?
Yeah, I got you.
Yeah, you got any other? Does that help?
Yeah, it makes sense. Like, totally.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, yeah, yeah. Do you want me to, do you have any questions about this, or do you want me to keep going with this, or do you want to do some flows?
Yeah, I don't have any questions right now. Like, what you're saying, like, you know, the way I deliver, like, I have to, you know, like, I don't know, it just makes sense, so.
Yeah, okay, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, no, that's straight. Yeah, then just think about it, you know? Like, even something to do is, like, to pay attention to when you're talking. Like, who do you live with?
I live with my friend now. Like, I moved out a while back, so I just talked to him, like.
Okay, so you got a roommate, right? Someone your age?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, so next time you're talking to him, listen to your voice. Listen to your voice, but pay attention to everything besides what you're saying. I mean, shit, dude, even go back to your room after you're done shooting the shit with him and, like, write down what you said and then try to pronounce it the same exact way. Because the first thing we need to do is we have to develop your ability to hear this. So, like, is there a certain phrase you always say? Like, for Eminem, at least in 8 Mile, they always say, like, what up, though? And then they put it in their rap. You know, like, are there certain jokes you always make? Are there certain words you always use? Is there a certain tone of voice you always take? Like, do you imitate people? You know, stuff like that. And then if you find a way to make your delivery more interesting, but you can do that by paying attention to how you talk, all right?
Yeah. Okay. I got a question, though.
Yeah.
Is this, like, lesson being recorded right now, or?
Yeah, how'd you know that?
Oh, no, I was asking because, you know, I just want to go over it later.
Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. So that's good, right?
Kind of forget it, you know?
Yeah, yeah. Okay, yeah, so you like that, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Do you want me to send it to you?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, 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 yeah. I'll record this and send it to you. And also, this little text block on the side is, like, for me, it's, like, if you go back to that later, those are suggestions. For what to do, like, fun little homework stuff and stuff like that. Yeah, so do you want to rap something, like, maybe the most recent thing you've done or the best thing you think you've done?
The best things, yeah.
Okay.
It's on my phone, but I don't know if I can, like, exit out of my phone and go on my notepad.
Okay, can you remember what it is?
Yeah, I think the first one...
Okay.
Yeah, I think I can remember. Well, like, when I write down, I kind of wanted to, because my favorite rapper right now is Chance the Rapper.
Oh, really? Dude, Chance is sick, man.
Yeah, exactly, and, like, his flow, and, like, I kind of want to go right on that, you know, just, like how he's delivering, and, like, how,
okay,
like,
okay, so you like Chance's like, delivery? You like Chance's flow?
Yeah, and, like, his rhyme scheme and stuff, and, like...
Yeah. Okay, yeah, that's real tight. I mean, we could even talk about that, because Chance has his own specific type of delivery, too. I mean, I don't want to call it, like, let's call it a childish delivery, right?
Yeah,
exactly, right? So, I mean, even Ultralight Beam, which I think was, like, the greatest verse of 2016,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
After he comes back in from singing, like, let me try to imitate it for you, just so you can start to know kind of what to pay attention for. And again, this is, like, his vocal register, right? He's treating his voice like an instrument. Because, like, it starts off, he raps, and then he sings. But once he goes back to rapping, it goes... They don't know. The part that starts... But you know the song, Ultralight Beam?
Yeah, it's, like, my favorite song on
the album. Yeah, exactly, right? So the Chance, to me, like, the Chance instrument... The ideal Chance instrument comes right here, where it's like, foot on the devil, I'm going to try and imitate him, and it will sound stupid, which just goes to show why everyone's voice is different from everyone else's. So he's like, foot on the devil's neck till it drifted Pangea. I'm moving all my family from Chatham to Zambia. Treat the demons just like Pam, I mean, I fuck with your friends, but damn, Gina. You know, like how he kind of like, it's almost like he constricts his voice, and then he pairs it down. But it sounds so, like, open and so honest, I guess. It just sounds so honest, you know, that's really
exactly what I kind of want to go for.
Okay, yeah, because another part of the Chance style is that he actually sings, right? So, like, Eminem raps like he's singing, but Chance actually sings while he raps, you know, because that's the opening part. And more people are doing this. I mean, Logic does it all the fucking time. Young Thug always does it. So for Chance, obviously, you know that part. It's the, I mean, even the opening. When they come for you, I will shield your name. I will field their questions. I will feel your pain. Yeah, and even the part where he's like, I mean, dude, the ending to the verse is so sick, right? Look, I mean, I won't even imitate it because it's so dope. But when he's like, you cannot mess with the light, look at Lil Channel from 79th. Or even he sings the fucking, this little light of mine, glory be to God, yeah? You know, so if you really like Chance, I can start pointing you in that direction, and we can work on stuff specifically like that. Add in some actual singing. Add in actual singing is another thing. Okay, yeah, that's good to know, actually, though. That's great to know. So do you want to try, have you written anything like Chance?
Well, like, because, you know, I can't sing, but, like, I guess this is, like, not the chill laid back, but, like, the honest one, I guess, is, like, because, you know, how I'm talking, because I felt like when I, I recorded it just to hear myself, and honestly, I would hate my voice, but then when I heard that, I was like, okay, I can deal with this, I like how I sound, because back then I would try to sound like gangster,
that's what I mean, man, like, leave all that shit behind. I mean, Kanye West did that, too. Like, I'm not knocking someone who actually sells drugs and then goes and raps about it. But, like, Kanye West is a great example. Because he's a great example of how being extremely honest in your art will make good art. Because he did, you know, and the Freshman Adjustment mixtape series that came out before College Dropout in 2004, before he got big, I mean, they were good. But, and so there he does rap about, like, selling drugs and having guns and shooting and stuff like that. But what happens when College Dropout rolls around, but he drops all that stuff, you know? So just make it a reflection of your life. And I can tell you from personal experience and from talking to other rappers that everyone hates their voice when they first start out recording themselves, you know? Until you get used to hearing it, until you hear feedback on it a few times. So, like, that's nothing new, you know? So just because you might hate your voice sometimes when it's recorded doesn't mean that it's actually bad. You're just getting used to it because your voice is different when you hear it recorded, right? Like, I'm still a little surprised because when I speak now, I'm actually hearing my voice through bone conduction. But when you hear your voice for on a recording, you're not. You're only hearing it only through your ear. So, like, yeah, that's completely normal. So, honestly, all right, chance, singing. Yeah, and so, like, and to be honest, bro, everyone can sing. Everyone can learn to sing. You know, I'm not saying we're all blessed with the voice of fucking, like, Whitney Houston or whoever. But, like, we can all sing, dude. I mean, even, like, Logic, dude. Even fucking Bob Dylan, dude. Bob Dylan just won a goddamn Nobel. That motherfucker cannot sing. Yeah, and that's just, like, that's provable, you know? But if you find a way to sound honest that people believe you, well, then it really doesn't matter whether you have a good actual voice or not.
The same thing with my singing. It's my vocal tone. Like, I have pitch and stuff because I have studied that for school. Like,
Yeah.
But it's, vocal tone is like, it's not there.
Yeah. I mean, and that, again, that just comes with practice. And we can work on it if you're talking about singing. But, like, as long as you're on pitch, people will forgive a lot of shit, you know? Like, pitch is greater than... In singing, not in rapping. But in singing, pitch is greater than actual... you call it timbre. Timbre is the sound quality of it. You know, you know what timbre is. What lets you tell a guitar apart from a piano, even though they're both playing middle C or whatever. Singing, pitch, timbre. Yeah, so do you want to try to do something you've written before?
Yeah. So, this is I'm working with my girlfriend on a song. It's called Jammin' or whatever. It's just about, like, music. And this is my verse to it.
Okay.
I'm trying to remember it.
Okay.
Alright. Okay, it's, music is my medicine. It moves me through this mess. It takes me where I've never been, from Gray Street to Neverland. It's safety and ecstasy when simple birds complexity. When simple words become a verse and carry on a new legacy. Music is the great divide, the only thing that conquers time. It helps me think, it helps me find a way to make this angel mine. And that's like my...
Nice.
Like, a verse, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, man, I'm feeling that. Yeah, so this is what I was talking about before, right? Is when you practice, is she playing?
Yeah, we both play the guitar, so like...
Okay. Yeah. Because I couldn't, you know, I'm trying to tell what is happening... Because you don't have a backing instrument and what is happening just even if the guitar was there. So the one thing I will say, yeah, I mean, it's kind of what I was talking about before, right? Is it was pretty obvious to tell. And like you said, I really like the writing. I think your writing is strong. I think to make this angel mine, that's a really good, strong ending verse, line to a verse. Because you got to remember, when people hear a verse for the first time, they remember, like,
the last line. Yeah,
they remember the first line and they remember the last line and not much else. So your feeling for structure is pretty good. What I might do is I might set up the angel line, either by like extending the metaphor or using the word angel beforehand so that like your final line is connected to what came before. But that's like a small thing. Because like you said, your delivery is really what matters. So your words, obviously... are really good, so that makes your delivery easier. But it was what I said before. It was kind of easy to tell that when you were doing that you were more worried about saying what you wanted to than saying it how you wanted.
Exactly.
And so, I don't think it's a matter. I mean, obviously you have the words memorized, so it's just a matter of like slowing down, actually taking breaths between sentences is important. And it's not important, it is important for your vocal structure, for the support of your breath, but it's also important for slowing your mind down. And once your mind is slow enough, then you know how to, change your voice so that it sounds convincing and good and honest. So let's work on that for a little bit then. Could you, what's your first line? The first line, I'm going to write it down. Oh, sorry, you cut out. What is it?
Did you get that?
No.
Music is my medicine.
All right. Great. What's your second line?
Moves me through this mess I'm in.
And what's the next line?
Takes me where I've never been.
And what's the fourth one?
From Gray Streets to Neverland.
Nice.
Like Neverland, like Peter Pan.
Yeah. Wow, yeah, that's really nice imagery. And what's the next line, just to make sure?
Music is the great divide.
Okay. Okay, sweet. Alright, so, yeah, you know, sometimes when we're learning to do something new, like have better rap delivery, we try to do too much. You know, we try to, like, eat the whole fucking cookie all at once, or whatever you want to say. But really, it just comes down to repetition of small parts. Repetition of small parts. So, like, it's great that you wrote the whole verse, but now we really, and I mean, this is what the best fucking rappers do, man. They think about every single syllable, and they hone it, and they cut it until it shines like a goddamn fucking diamond. So that's why we're only going to work on your first few lines. Because, like, every line has to be awesome. So that's why we work on it in such detail, to talk about it line to line and not just verse to verse. So, like, what I would say is, like, probably what you, maybe other people have said to you, is, like, your voice was kind of monotone, like you only stayed on one pitch, and then that kind of just gets boring.
Yeah, exactly.
And then you were kind of rushing your rhythms a lot. So, like, I would just work on only those four lines for now, and just repeat them until you're really happy with them. And so, like, I'm gonna do it because you kind of did it like, music is my medicine, moves me through this mess I'm in, takes me where I've never been, from great streets to Neverland. And, like, that's cool, but then it's just, like, poetry, right? Like, when I hear that, I kind of feel like I'm just being read to out of a book. And that's why, like, you should also always memorize your lyrics before you perform them. Which it seems like you, I mean, which you did, but it also helps in moving forward when you're trying to improve your delivery in other places. Because some people will just, like, perform with it written down, you know? Never work from written down lyrics. Because then you just don't have the feelings internalized, you know? So always practice aloud and memorize your lyrics, are what I would say. And so then this part. Music is my medicine. Moves me through this mess of me. Music is my medicine. So now we're trying to, like, find a way to pronounce these words that isn't monotone, that is honest, and the other kind of things you said about Chance, like laid back, chill, but mostly honesty, I guess, is the most thing, and convincing. You know, I want to be convinced, like, you basically have to find a way to say, music is my medicine, which convinces me that music is your medicine. Like, that's the fucking goal here, right? Like, you gotta believe, like, I'm, like, your teacher or something, and, like, you're, like, doing a debate in front of me, and you gotta convince me that music is my medicine. So, and eventually, in writing this line, you might find out that music is my medicine isn't really what you mean. Maybe you mean something similar, like, music is my drug or whatever, but there's always this back and forth, like Jean Grey says in that interview, so please read those interviews when you got time. But, like, some words you can say, and some words you can't. You know, like, I always think of, like, you know the Wu-Tang Clan?
Yeah, I don't listen to much of their music, though.
Yeah. But one of their rappers is named Ghostface Killa. And
yeah, I know.
Yeah, exactly, right? But, like, the word Killa, as in K-I-L-L-A-H, it's just a word I can't say. Like, I don't feel comfortable saying it. I'm not, like, at home. You know, like, it's not something I would say in everyday speech, and it just comes off awkward sounding to me when I say it, so I stay away from it. So you might find out that maybe one of these words is like that, like music, maybe doesn't sound good when I say it, or like medicine. So there's always this back and forth that good delivery makes good words, good text, good poetry, but good poetry also helps build good delivery. So let me write that down. Helps build good poetry, and good poetry helps build good delivery. All right, so now we're gonna work on your delivery for these, and I'm gonna take a few shots at it. And obviously it's tough for me because this is what I've been telling you the whole time, is that you have to write what you feel. So, like, music is my medicine, but I would never write that rap line. So I'm gonna take a few shots at it, and we're just gonna kind of trade these back and forth. All right, so when we trade doing these lines back and forth, really try to pay attention to how your voice is moving up and down, and stuff like that. Okay, that cool?
Yeah, I'm just putting my charger in.
Okay, yeah. I'll wait. Music is my medicine. Music is my medicine.
Okay, yeah, I'm good.
Alright, you cool? Alright, yeah. So obviously also rhythm has a big thing to do with this. It's like, I'm going to put a rhythm on it on the same words that you might put a different rhythm on. Because someone could say it like, music is my medicine. You know, that's like a 80s flow. Like almost, no, earlier. Like almost like a real, that's like a fucking Curtis Blow on the breaks, man. Where it's like, music is my medicine. Moves me through this mess I'm in. So you also got to think about like the rhythm. So clearly that's not going to work for us. But like, so for me, for my rhythm, I forget exactly how you do it. But the rhythm I would want to do is like, music is my medicine. Almost like a spoken verb, like I take a break in between music and is. And again, we're looking for a way for me to say this word that it sounds honest and convincing, you know? So maybe something like, 1, 2, 3, 4. Music is my medicine. So there I kind of start high and then go low. But I was doing it like, how about music is my medicine. Music is my medicine. So it's almost like there I had like a question. I asked myself a question and then I answered it. So music went up and then is my medicine went down. Right? So there it's almost like I asked myself like, what do you think of music? And then I put like, I think it is my medicine, right? So now I'm showing you how the same line can be delivered lots of different ways. And you got to pick the one that when you hear it, you're like, that's exactly what I meant, you know? So sometimes it's changing the text or not that. So for me, that's probably the way I like it most. Like, music is my medicine, you know? Because then it's like, to me, it's like, I'm just being honest with you, you know? Like, I'm not telling you how much I love music. Because, I mean, all those people wear those fucking t-shirts like, J Dilla saved my life. You know, you ever seen those t-shirts?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I always see that and I want to be like, really? J Dilla saved your fucking life? How about, like, your parents who paid all your bills? Or, like, the school you went to? Or, like, the job you got, you know? So just for me, like, my love of music isn't, I try to not make it flashy, you know? I just try to have it be that thing that's always there for me. So now, when I make my delivery, I try to do it in a similar way, right? So I make it, music is my medicine. And I keep my voice up because that gives me somewhere to go, right? Like, you don't want to answer your question in a way that doesn't leave you anywhere to go. So if I did, like, music is my medicine, well, then it kind of sounds like it's over. Because when people answer a question in everyday conversation, they let their voice go down, right? You know, your mom's like, oh, where are you going? And you're like, just to the store. And then it's like over. The conversation is over and you've left. So when you rap, you can't have that happen, you know? So I want to keep my voice up. Like, music is my medicine. Rather than music is my medicine. So music is my medicine. And then by staying high, it lets me go low on the next line. Because, like, you don't want to show right away everything that you're going to do. You know, you got to save it. You know how like a boxer saves his big right hook for the end of the round or whatever. You want to save that low space so you can't touch it yet because you're going there later. So what's the next line? Music is my medicine. Moves me through this mess I'm in. You know? So music is my medicine kind of stayed high and then moves me through this mess I'm in went low. All right? So it's like, music is my medicine. Sorry. Music is my medicine. Moves me through this mess I'm in. All right? And so this is kind of how we want to be thinking about it, is all of this stuff, eventually at the same time, the more and more we work on it, whether it's your vocal tone, how many notes you have. Like, just for me, I know that a better way to make, a way to improve my delivery is to add as many notes as possible to the line, which is why me rapping something like this is a little uncomfortable, because music is my medicine. Like, that to me, that just leaves a lot of musical space. Because I feel like as long as I'm filling the musical space with syllables, notes, and rhythms, I'm always giving the listener something new to pay attention to. So they can't focus on any one part of my rap. And I do that purposefully. So I would add in syllables like, music, well, yeah, it's my medicine. Just for my delivery, you know, because I like to always have something to constantly say. Music, well, yeah, it's my medicine. You know, just like that. Because I also talk like that, as you can probably tell. Like, lots of asides, now I'm here, now I'm there. So why don't you just try, this will feel odd, but why don't you just try to say music is my medicine in three different completely ways while rapping it? Just two completely different ways.
Just the first line? Or
yeah, just the first line. And doesn't have to be good, just different. Just different. Not good, better. Two different ways. Yeah, just try it. Anything you got.
Z. I guess I go high.
Okay.
So, music? No,
all your way. Don't try to imitate me. But, like, you know, you did your way when you first did it for me. So just try to do it that way, incorporating the concepts we talked about. Because I think you did it like, music is my medicine. So you didn't do that pause that I had, right? So why don't you just try to do it that way, but without the kind of monotone, that single pitch. You could do, like, music is my medicine. You know, like, kind of end high. Almost like the whole line is a question. But, like, again, does not matter. We're just trying to get those parts of your brain to start paying attention to this.
Okay.
Which is why I asked you to write down conversations you have with your roommate and people like that. All right? So, anything you got.
Okay. Music is my medicine. Music is my medicine. I don't know. Is that still monotone?
It's still a little monotone. Let's do this. All right. Okay. Music is my medicine. Say it like you're angry. Say it like you're angry at music.
Music is my medicine.
Oh, come on, man. You're mad at it. You're not, like, talking to it in a crowded room. You're pissed off at it. Like, music just fucked your girlfriend.
Music is my medicine.
There you go. There you go. Hold on. When people are angry, they talk louder, right? And they talk with more of a growl, like a growl in their voice, right? So it'd be like, music is my medicine, you know? Like, that's what we're going for. And again, we're just going for different. We're not going for good or better yet. It's just like, music is my medicine. Like, if you were fucking, who raps? Like, Big V from Nappy Roots or fucking, like, who else is an angry rapper? Like Eminem on his angry songs, you know? So that's like angry. What if you were like sad? How do people talk when they're sad?
Lower, I guess. I mean.
Lower? More quiet, right?
Yeah.
More unsure of themselves?
Yeah.
Maybe more halting. Like they're not like, music is my medicine. They're like, music is my medicine, you know? So try to say that line like you're sad now.
Alright, music is my medicine.
Alright, man, give your voice more extreme. Like, music is my medicine. Music is my medicine.
Music is my medicine.
Lighter.
Music is my medicine.
Do it more quietly.
Music is my medicine.
That was the same volume, bro. Quieter.
Alright. Music is my medicine.
Even as quietly as you possibly fucking can.
Music is my medicine.
Thank you, yes! And that was it. That was it. Because you thought about how we talk in real life, and then you put it in your rap. You just sounded sad as fuck, bro. You sound like music has, like, abandoned you. Or like you were somehow, like, thrown in jail. And then you couldn't listen to music, and you're sitting there rapping, and I just felt that. I felt what it would have been like to be without music, you know? And it's real simple. It might not be as tricky as, like, we think it is. It's just like, music is my medicine. Music is my medicine, you know? And that's all it takes, all right? So it's angry, sad. What about, like, happy? Like, you're fucking pumped. You're fucking, what's a really happy song? Like Kanye West Through the Wire, bro. Like, that fucking happy. How would you say music is my medicine if you were happy?
I'm more high-pitched, like, I guess, yeah.
Yeah, exactly, right? And you would probably go up. So it would be like, music is my medicine! You know? Now we're not even... Yeah, now we're just talking about how we say things. So, yeah, if you were going to do it happy, how would you do it?
Like, you know, like, music is my medicine.
Yes, thank you. There you go. Now we're at least getting different stuff, right? And now we want to put this all together, keep working on it, but, you know, say it sad, happy, angry. What would you say it if you were, like, secret? If you had a secret? If you were, like, a fucking spy?
like, whisper it, right?
Yeah, just to fuck it, just to fuck with the other person's mind. Like, what's a song like that? Like, oh God. Yeah. How would you say it if you were like secret?
Like whispering, like, you know, music is my medicine.
Yeah, actually, yo, could you give me, like, 1 minute? This is my doctor. I gotta see what this is about. Do you mind?
Yeah.
Just give me 30 seconds, yeah.
Yes, okay.
Hello? Yes, this is he. I'm good. How are you doing today? Oh, yes. Yeah, that's great. I'll be there. All right, perfect. Thanks so much. Bye now. All right, sorry. They were just confirming an appointment. So, like, I mean, like, a spy. I mean, someone who's, like, holding a secret where, like, they're fucking with the other person. Where they're, like, music is my met... Nah, how... I guess it's not really a line that you could say, like, secretively. But, yeah, just give me that. If you were a spy and your code message was music is my medicine, how would you say it? And, like... You're being hunted by the police right now, and they're trying to kill you. And you're on the radio with your fucking headquarters, and you're delivering this message. How would you say music is my medicine?
Like, whispering? Like,
yeah.
Music is my medicine or something.
Yeah, like, yeah, maybe whispering, but whispering really loudly, you know? Like, music is my medicine. Oh, dude, it's the fucking Whisper song. Jesus. You ever hear that song?
No.
I think it's the Yang Yang Twins. Okay, yeah. So, anyway, so, hopefully, is that helpful to you?
Yeah, it's really helpful.
Okay, good, good. Yeah, so this is what we want to think about, man. So, so now you have a whole bunch of different exercises to go home and work on, right? You could do, and especially writing the same line and rapping it a number of different ways is really helpful, too. But also to read through those interviews and say the same line a million different ways, like happy, sad, angrily, furtive, like secretly, sexually, other shit like that, whatever else. Okay? Yeah, that's a full hour though. So do you want to sign up for another lesson though, or do you want to do it, you want to just email me again?
Yeah, because, you know, I get paid bi-weekly, so I guess every 2 weeks I'd be paying 35 and then, you know, 20, and then, like, every other week would be, because, you know, I'm not really, but you know how it is.
Yeah, no, that's
like, true. Money, and then, like, by the second week, it's just, like, nothing's there.
Yeah, no, that's cool. Don't sweat it. Where do you work at?
Well, right now, I was working at a commissary, but I quit, and now I'm going to work at, like, a car dealership or something.
Okay, cool. Yeah. Well, good luck with that. So you just want to email me?
Yeah, I'll email you. Okay. Sometime next week. But today's Friday, right? By next Friday, I guess.
Okay, yeah. Hit me up, man. Yeah, and just think about all that stuff when you're performing that song with your girlfriend. Really try to make your voice move up and down.
Okay, right? Can you send me the video, too? Because I want to, like, you know.
Watch it? Yeah. Yeah, I got it now. It's kind of big, because, I mean, I've been recording this whole hour, so I'll throw it on YouTube and send you a link, though. That cool?
Okay, yeah.
All right, fucking sweet, man. Yeah, so was that helpful? That was good?
Yeah, it was really good. I mean I've had a professor for guitar.
Yeah.
And, like, this is like, the same thing, but you're really in-depth with all the material. And,
okay,
like,
good.
It's not like you're a music teacher. You know, you're trained to do it like that.
Oh, thanks,
man. Like I said, with Drew or whatever, it was just, you know, like, it was different. Way different. Like.
Yeah, exactly. No, yeah. I got your back, bro. Honestly, I love this shit too much to ever, like, let an email like yours go unanswered. And honestly, that means a lot for you when you give me feedback. Because just like when you're trying to become a better rapper, I'm trying to become a better rapper and a better music teacher too, you know? So yeah, I'm all yours though. But yeah, just hit me up and we'll get it going. Yeah, I look forward to your email, man.
All right. Okay, thanks.
Yeah, peace. Have a good day.